Welcome to my channel. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe and turn on the notification bell to get our latest post. So in this tutorial, we are going to design a church flyer, just a simple church flyer. So navigate to your home screen, then look for your Canva app. Here's my Canva app. So tap on it, it will open. So this is the background of your home page of your Canva app. So what we are going to use, this size. So look for the size to use. Let's see. Okay, so we are going to use this Instagram post. That's the size we are going to use. So you tap on it, you will see some other things here. Can see already designed templates, but we are not going to make use of that. Okay, we are not going to make use of this design template. So we tap on the blank, template, tap on it, it will open. Wait a little. So we are going to design it from the scratch. The reason why we are using Canva is because of its resolution. If you want to make use of a Pixel Lab, the resolution is poor, so we'll make use of Canva, so the resolution will be up. Okay, so draw it down from here. Okay, so now this, let me show you some of the tools here. These buttons is for adding. When you want to add anything, you use this button. Then the button up here is for download after designing. If you want to save, you use that button. Okay, this will take you to the home. Okay, so now we want to add, we use this button. Okay, so I'll tap on the plus sign. I want to upload a photo. So I'll use this from my gallery, or you can also get an image from Canva. So since it's a church flyer we are going to design, so let me get the image from Canva itself. So I'll tap on gallery. So I'll wait for it to load. Okay, so I'm choosing an image from my phone. Okay, so let me make use of this image. First of all, before you head on to design, you must have looked for the image you are going to use from either online or anywhere. Okay, so I tap on the image. Here's the image I'm going to use. So I'll drag it to the extreme here and use this circle to enlarge it. Okay, look at it, it will fill in the background. Okay, so that's that. So I'll tap on the add button again. Okay, I'll use the gallery. So I'm going to use this thumb paper. This is called thumb paper. Okay, you can get it from Google. Just type thumb paper, it will give you. Okay, so I'll drag it to the extreme again. This time around, I will enlarge it to fill it. Okay, enlarge it this way. Okay, you can use this button to rotate it. Let's see, I'll rotate it like this. Okay, you can use it this way, rotating. Okay, so I've gotten that. So I'll tap outside. Okay, now we are building up our flyer. So what we need again, we need the same thumb paper down here. So just tap on the thumb paper and duplicate. Here is duplicate, the plus sign, and this is delete. So tap on duplicate, it's been duplicated. So we reduce it a little bit, drag it, then rotate. We rotate it, okay? Take it down this way. Take it down this way. We need it here, okay? We need it somewhere here, okay? That's where we need it. So now I will place a shape. So I'll place a shape here to reduce the opacity of the image, of the background image, okay? So let's say I'll place a shape. So I'll tap on the plus sign. This is the plus sign to add a shape. So I'll tap on it. So if you can see now, you see shapes, element. Shape is under element. So I'll tap on element. Tap on element. So I'll make use of a rectangle. Okay, so this is the rectangle I want to use. This is the rectangle. Okay, you tap on the rectangle. Okay, here you change the color. Change the color. There is the position. If you drag it this other way, you see some other things. And this is the opacity. Okay, so I'll change the color. Let's see, I'll make use of purple. Okay, so let's make use of purple. Let's make use of purple something. Something this. Okay. So I'm making use of this, so I'll drag it over my image, drag it to cover it. Okay, so you go to the position. Here is the position. Tap on the position. If you can see, you see backward, you see middle, bottom. So we'll tap on backward because the shape is already upward, it's already at the front. So tap on the backward. See what will happen. Tap on it again. Yes, so this is what we need. So now we'll use our transparent tool. Tap on the transparent. Okay, so the more you increase, the more you decrease, the more the image decreases. Okay, so let's say we move it like this and see what we are doing now. Can see what we are doing. Okay, so we have gotten what we want. So now we'll tap outside. Okay, so now we have set up our background, so we can now add our text, any text you want to use. Okay, so the program is pray for the world. Okay, so tap on the plus sign down here again. The plus sign. Tap on the plus sign. Tap on text. Tap on text. So you can choose any of the text here. You can make use of any of the text here, the one that fits your design. So I'm choosing this one. So I'm making use of this one. Okay. And group. Ungroup it. Okay, so I will type, you see edit down here, you can see edit. So I'll tap on the edit button. So let's say pray, it's capital letter, pray. Okay, so I'll increase it this way, make it bigger. Okay, so I'll make it bigger. So here you can change the font. Here's the font I'm using. Here you can change the size. You can change the color here. You can make it bold or italic. You can make it you can underline it. Okay, so many things you can do here. Then the effect, meaning we want to add let's say a shadow under. Okay, so we tap on the effect. You can see the type of shadow effect here. Okay, so those are the things you can add to it. So you can add a shape, you can add the style. Okay, so we have added the effect. You have added the effect you want to use. So these are the things you can do after adding the effect. If you want to edit it to your own text, you look at this stuff, tap on it again, it will open up. You can make it blur just like that. You can change the color of the shadow. Let's say this. Okay, let's make use of red. Okay, let's make use of red. Okay, make use of red. Can change the direction. Change the direction. Make it come out this way. Can make it come out the other way. Can make it blur. You don't want it blur. Okay, want it to stand out. This is the transparency. This is the blur. This is the direction. Offset. Okay, so we'll tap outside. So this is our prey now. I'll shift it up a little bit. Okay, so let's add another text. Let's look for a fancy coffee font that we can make use of. Okay, make use of a fancy font. Okay, let's make use of this one. Tap on it. Okay, so let's edit it. We need for the word, erase it for the word. Okay, so we reduce it a little, drag it this way. We reduce it a little again. We reduce it. Okay, so now let's edit it. So let's change the color to change the color to your taste, what you like. Okay, so change the effect on it. Okay, change the effect on it. You can make it all capital letter or you leave it this way. Okay, so you can see what we are doing. If you want to change the font, this is where to change the font. So if you tap on it, let's see what we get. Let's look for this font. Any font you see with the crown like this, it means it is a premium font. It means it is a premium font. So we don't make use of that. Don't make use of any font with this. Okay, so you go down. Let's check out this. Okay, no, that will not suit in our design. Let's go look for another font again. Okay, let's check out this. It's not so fitting. It's not also fitting the design. Let's check out this. That will not fit in the design also. Let's check out this. Sorry, because of time, I will have to make use of any font. But as you are designing, look for a font that will best suit your design, okay? So I'll place it there. You can see what I'm doing, okay? You can see our design is coming to life, okay? So now we add the date, add another text, tap on the text to add another text, okay? Add another text, move it up. Let's move it up, take it up this way. That's where I want to place my date. So let me change the color so that I can see what I'm doing. Change the color to this. So I'll drag it a little bit and edit it. Here is the edit button. So let's say 15th, or let's say 20th. Okay, so I'll increase it, use the upside to increase, let's say this. Okay, so I want to add another text, so I will duplicate. No need of going to look for text. I'll duplicate it like this, then I'll edit it. Let's say we need to, the event to take place in May. Take place in May. So I reduce it, the size. Okay, reduce the size and put it under this way. Reduce the size. Okay, reduce the size. Reduce the size. Let's reduce it again. Okay, so now let's add the what, the day, the date. This is the day. Okay, this is the month and this is the date. So let's add the days of the week. Let's say it's a Sunday. Okay, so let's say the event will take place on Sunday. Event will take place on what? On Sunday. Let's use for a smaller font. Let's look for a smaller font that will fit in. Okay, let's make use of this. The video is becoming long, okay? So let's make use of this. I'll ungroup it, then delete this other one. Okay, so I'll take it here. I'll change the color to the color I'm using. I'll change it to purple. Okay, so now you can now rotate it. So I want to rotate it this way, okay, so that it will fit in, because I want to place it here. Okay, so I'll edit it, change it to Sunday. Okay, so I want it like this. The event will take place on a Sunday. Okay, so I've gotten that. Sorry, it's not accurate because of I'm making use of my hand. If it's on a system, it will be better. If it's on a system, it will be what better. Increase it again, increase the size. Take the Sunday to it. Let's see here. Okay. So we have gotten that. We have gotten what we wanted. Let's reduce this one again. Okay, so we have gotten what we want. I've gotten what we want. So we have gotten what we want there. So we'll add the upside. She's let's say we'll add another text. She's the church name, Bible of the church name. So let's add the name of the church. Okay, instead let's just tap on this the Sunday and duplicate. Let's duplicate it, we rotate it. Okay, stick it up here. So add the name of the church. Let's say name of the church is this Bible of Christ Church. That's the name of the church. So now we change the color. Let's make it white so that it will come up. Okay, so make it white. Make it white. So let's duplicate it. So add what present. So what are they presenting? Let's say present. Present, pray for the world. So present. Give it a space just like this so that it will give it a space. Give it a space. Give it a space. Two space. Give it two space. Present. Present what? Sorry, you have to do it this way. I don't want to rush the video so that you will understand. Present. So present capital letter. Present. Okay, that's what we want. So drag it up under here. Okay, so it seems we are going to reduce this. Reduce it a little. Increase this. Okay. So we have gotten that. Push this one down so that it will give the upper one a space. Okay. So if you see the position, the way the flyer is going this way. Look at it. So you have to understand as you are designing. So let's change the direction of our design. Okay. Okay, can you see now that is making a difference? So it's making a little difference. Okay. So we have gotten that now. So what we need again is I will not complete that. What we need again, we need the pastor's name. Let's say the speaker. The speaker. Sky this one up. Okay. Okay. So let's group this so that we can move them around. Okay, so to group, let me show you how to group your text. Long press on this, the one you want to group. So I will long press on it. Something like this will come up. One element selected. So tap on the one you want to group with. Okay. So long press on it. Tap on the one you are grouping with. So you see something down here, group. So I'll group it, okay, so that I can move them together when I will want to move, so it will not be scattered. So it won't be scattered. So let me group this other one. Okay, so let me group this other one. I'll long press on it, select this other one, then group. Okay, so now I can move the two together. You can see what I'm doing now. So what we need is the speaker. Let's say this stock, stop on that. Okay, so stop on that, edit. Okay, let's duplicate, bring this one down this way. So ungroup it so that we can edit one by one. So this is what we want to do. Take this up, bring this down. Okay, so this will carry the speaker. Let's say this speaker. The speaker. Speaker. You have to be patient as you are designing. That's how it is. That's how hard it is. So you have to be patient. Okay. So this is the speaker to be done here. Okay. So this is the name of the speaker. Let's reduce it. Reduce this one. Okay. So the name of the speaker, let's say okay, let me use mic because so many pastors answered that. So let's say Pastor Michael. Okay. So let's say Pastor Michael Johnson. Johnson. Okay. So let's make the speaker name bold. The church name, let's make it bold. Okay. So we have gotten that. So let's say watch it online or anything like that. Let's say the contact information. Okay, so copy this, duplicate it, take it down here, change the color so that it will be visible. Change the color to, let's make it purple. Okay, use it. Let's say let's say this, let's edit it, let's say let's say watch it online, say watch it online, put the church website, let's say church website, let's say choose the church name, let's say Bible, say Bible Christ, say Bible of Christ, Christ.com. That's the church name. That's the church website, rather. Church website. Okay. Reduce it so that it will enter. Okay, let's bring this other shape down a little. Other shape down. Okay. Okay, so let's give it a color. Give it a color. This, let's make it better still yellow, more yellowish. Let's give it a color yellow. Yes, no. So it will be visible. Okay, so we are giving it that color. Okay, let's group this other one with the speaker name. Let's group it. Okay, so we can move it around. Let's reduce this one a little. Okay. So this is the website. Okay. Okay. So this is the church website. This pastor's name. Okay, so that's how to design a simple church flyer. Thanks for watching, and this, if you have any question pertaining to this, you can ask me. Okay, thank you. So after designing, you use this to save. Tap on this, it will save as image. It's preparing to save. Okay. So that's our image. So let's view the image. Let's view what we have done. Let's view what we have done. Okay, now. So if you can see the resolution, if you can testify the resolution of Canva is different from PixelLab. So this is better if you ask me. So that's how to design a simple church flyer. Thank you.